Thank you, Dr. Banda Prakash.
Thank you very much.
Subhash Chandra Bose ji.
Respected panel chairman, ma'am.
You have 6 minutes.
Thank you very much for giving the opportunity to speak on demands for grant to railways for this current financial year. Ma'am, I would like to utilize this short time to mention the long pending project in our home state of Andhra Pradesh. Ma'am, I request the Honorable Minister, so many long pending projects are pending in Andhra Pradesh. I request the Honorable Minister to allocate sufficient funds for early and speedy progress of the pending projects. Ma'am, there are about 11 long pending projects, which are: 1. New line Macharla to Vinukonda project of length 65 kilometers, which is pending since 2011. Tenali Repalle double line project of 37 kilometers length, and Pakala Tirupati double line 41.94 kilometers. Mahabubnagar Gutti double line of length 240 km, Dharmavaram Pakala double line of km 227.70 km, Singaraikonda Kanigiri new line of 66.53 km, Narsapur Machilipatnam new line of 85 km, Darsi Narsapet of new line of 65 km. These are all pending projects in the state of Andhra Pradesh. The Kakinada Narsapur via Kotipalli new line project, the construction is of the bridge on the river Godavari at Kotipalli has already been started, but the work is completely slowed down. I don't know what is the reason. I request the Honorable Minister, please review once the progress of this bridge, construction of the bridge, and issue suitable orders to the concerned authorities for speedy completion of the work. Like another an important pending project is to link up the Kakinada town to Samarlakota Petapuram main line. This is also a long pending project. From 2 decades, it is pending with the government, with the railway department for 2 decades. The project is a long-pending desire and demand of people of East Godavari of Andhra Pradesh. Long-pending desire and demand. All the paperwork has already been completed. The railway department has also agreed for this proposal. The only pending is the allocation of funds is the only pending for this project. I request the Honorable Minister, please look into the matter and sanction the funds, required funds, at the earliest possible convenience. I would like to draw the attention of the Honorable Railway Minister towards the pending provisions of the AP Reorganization Act 2014. Under AP Reorganization Act 2014, the Government of India had assured the people of AP a new railway zone comprising of 3 divisions, one Guntakal, Guntur and Vijayawada, with its headquarters at Visakhapatnam. The decision announced the formation of South Coast Railway is a testimony to the resilience of the people of Andhra Pradesh. More than 4 years of struggle inside and outside the parliament lay behind our
Honorable Member,
rightful demand for this declaration, but no positive reply from the Ministry of Railways till today. In the end, I would like to thank the Indian Railways for providing services during COVID-19 pandemic. Like the railways manufacturing are being used to manufacturing items like PPE kits, beds, medical trolleys, etc. Railways also provided bulk cooked food to the nearby places where IRCTC base kitchens are located.
The coaches were converted to isolation wards, and railways are also opened the hospitals for COVID patients. I congratulate the railways for such a service rendering to our nation.
Honourable Member, please conclude.
Finally, on behalf of our YSR Congress Party, support the demand for this current financial year proposed by Honourable Minister. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Honourable Finance Minister.
Thank you. Vishwamba.